Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I have an updated tutorial for you. We are going to make a 10-inch ruler to make a t-shirt. So let's go ahead and get started. Over here on designbundles.net, this is the SVG that I purchased. Now it's also a PNG, EPS, DFX. You can use this with your laser machines and all of that stuff. Now for me today, I'm gonna be utilizing this with my Cricut Explore Air 2. So I wanted to do an updated video because you guys absolutely love the last one, but you guys know that I requested a 10-inch ruler and they did it, yay! So let's go ahead and cut this out and make a t-shirt. All right, so now we're ready to go. We're over here in Cricut Design Space. I've uploaded my SVG file. Now, when you get over here and bring it in, you're gonna notice it's in a lot of pieces. So this is how we're gonna quickly get it ready to go. So this piece right here, the basic cut, which is the main piece, it's ready to go, ready for cut. The rest of it, we need to change to a draw because we don't wanna cut those. And I also wanna get rid of where it says draw layer and cut layer because we don't need those. So if you notice below the basic cut right here, all of these letters right here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select those, I'm gonna hit one, and then I'm gonna hit shift on my laptop, and then I'm gonna select the rest of them. And I'm gonna hit delete. Now, let's go ahead and get rid of draw layer. So if you look right here, you can actually read it. It says draw layer. I'm gonna do the same thing. Click on it, hit shift, and delete. All right, so now we've got rid of all of that stuff. Now everything else, all we have to do is select all of it and hit attach. All right. Now that I have everything selected, the only thing I did not select was this one right here. Now another thing you could do is you could hit select all, that would be a lot easier, and then unselect this one by holding down the shift and clicking this one. That would be a lot faster. And then I'm gonna come down here and hit attach. I'm not gonna hit weld, I just need to hit attach. All right, so now I wanna come up here to the operation settings and bring it down and see where it says draw. I wanna change it to pin. And if you want to, you can click right here and change the color. Now for me, I'm only using one pen. I'm not swapping out, so I'm not even gonna mess with it. So now I wanna make sure that this is gonna draw right on top of this cutout. I don't want it to be separated. I wanna make sure it's doing it all in the same spot. So what I'm gonna do is hit select all. And you can see where it says detach, so it's already attached. So if it didn't and it said attach, you would wanna hit attach. So now if we go to make it, you're gonna notice that everything is gonna be in one spot. So we're ready to go. We don't need to mirror anything. We're gonna go ahead and hit continue. I'm gonna go ahead and switch you guys over to the machine. Over here, I'm gonna turn this to custom. All right, so now we have all of these settings to choose from. I'm gonna go ahead and hit browse all material and type in craft board. So the one that we're using today is this holographic. I'm gonna click on it. Now you may be using something different. Maybe you just wanna use cardstock, a heavy cardstock. You can use whatever you would like. I'm gonna go ahead and hit done and we are ready to go. All right, so now we're ready to do this. So I'm using the blue mat today because it has less tack. It's gonna be a lot easier to peel, like, you know, your papers and cardstocks and all those things off. So what I'm using today is that holographic craft board. So you can see here, it's got holographic on one side. I did this in my last video. I like it because it's very sturdy. So you can use a thick cardstock, whatever you would like. Now, if you did like the black craft board, you could use, you know, a white pen. So that way you can see it on there like so. So I'm gonna go ahead and load this. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and load it in the machine. And I'm gonna go ahead and load my pen at the same time. Today I'm using one of their extra fine point pens. You can use whatever. I'm just using a color today. I'm gonna go ahead and load this in the machine, holding the bottom here, popping that in, shutting the door, and we're ready to go. All right, so we're ready to unload it. And you can simply just peel like this. I'm just kind of pushing on my board and start peeling. Now, the way to get this to where it's not going to curl, the best thing to do is actually lay it down on your surface and then peel away your mat. Just like so. So there you have it. So now we have that 10-inch ruler. I think this is the perfect size, so I'm really, really excited. Huge thank you guys for listening to me and making this possible. I'm so excited. So let's go ahead and make a t-shirt. So I've got my t-shirt here. I've already pre-pressed it for 5 seconds. I've already got my heat press ready to go. I've got it at 305 for 12 seconds. I'm gonna go ahead and find my center here just by folding it in half and getting that crease mark. Now we're gonna take our ruler and get it right up here at the top so we can get this right underneath the neckline there, and that's gonna be perfectly our 3 fingers down. And don't worry about this kind of going right around that. The point of that is just kind of getting up against the neckline, because they're always going to be different, whether it's small, medium, large. So just get that right there, and that's going to be your center. So you just want to center this up. So there's my center. So now I can take my design here and line this up. Just like so. It's only gonna cost you a few cents to make. I'm sure you've got, you know, scrap craft board or cardstock laying around, and you're gonna get it perfect every single time. So let's go ahead and press the t-shirt. All right, so we're over here at the heat press. We're ready to go. I'm gonna pull this out just a little bit and load our t-shirt. Push it in and press it down for 12 seconds. All right, that is it. Now this is a hot peel, so I'm gonna go ahead and peel it right up. So let's go ahead and head back to the table. So there you have it, an absolutely perfect t-shirt. You're gonna get that perfect every single time using this ruler. What I love about this, not only is it absolutely perfect now at 10 inches, you're gonna get that perfectly down from the neckline, straight across. These are basically free, cheap to make. You can use copy paper, whatever you want to, laying around the house. If it gets gunked up, torn, lost, I can totally make another one. So I absolutely love that. Once again, you could definitely use your laser as well and make an acrylic if you wanted to. You could sell these, all of the things. So let me know down below, will you guys be making your own ruler? And also, what do you think about the t-shirt? I love this design. I made it for my sister-in-law because today is her birthday and I think she'll love it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.